Number 7. The Devil's Sea, also known as Dragon's Triangle and the Pacific Bermuda Triangle. This is a region of the Pacific Ocean that's south of Japan, in which several ships have disappeared, notably the Japanese research vessel Kaiyo Maru No. 5 in the early 1950s. Sailors have reported problems with electronic instruments and sightings of unmanned ghost ships. American author and linguist Charles Berlitz made the area around Miyake Island famous with his book, The Dragon's Triangle, in 1989. Although authorities claim the Kaiyo Maru was destroyed by natural forces while the crew was investigating the eruption of an underwater volcano, Berlitz attributed the incident to unknown supernatural forces, and even blamed the Dragon's Triangle for the disappearance of aviation pioneer Amelia Earhart. Number 6. The Dyatlov Pass. On the morning of February 2, 1959, a group of students set out on their hike to Dyatlov Pass, telling their friends that they would be in contact by the 12th. When the call didn't come, they sent out a search party over a week later, and it would take another 6 days before they found the first signs of interaction. As they walked along the path that the students took, they came across their tents, which had been ripped open from the inside. They also found almost all of their belongings along with their clothing. To the right of the tent, they saw footprints leading away that appeared as though the students were barefoot. As they followed the footprints, they began to find bodies, and about a half mile from the tent, they found the remains of a fire along with the first two bodies nearly naked, only in their underwear. As they continued to scour the scene, they noticed a set of three more footprints which led back to the tent, and three bodies which were spread around 100 and 150 meters apart. The furthest body was 630 meters from the tent, and the other two students fell well before that. The remaining four were found months later, buried under just a few meters of snow. However, unlike their friends, it would seem that they died of hypothermia. Many of them had severe skull and chest fractures, while one was missing her eyes and her tongue. The coroner would say that the fractures could not have been dealt by any kind of human and were far too specific to have a product of an avalanche be involved. The students also had strange brown and orange tints to their skin, along with discoloration in their hair. But what baffled investigators the most was that there were no other tracks leading to the bodies other than those of the students themselves. The official cause of death in the coroner's report would be an unknown compelling force. And to this day, almost 60 years later, the scene remains unsolved. What do you guys think happened? Number 5. The South Atlantic Anomaly. You've heard of the Bermuda Triangle. You may have even heard of its Pacific counterpart, the Devil's Sea near Japan. But did you know about the South Atlantic Anomaly? It's a region over South America and the South Atlantic Ocean centered around 30 degrees west and 30 degrees south. And it's big, a little larger than the entire United States. Some say it's a danger to anything entering it, and they point most specifically to the crash of Air France Flight 447 in June of 2009, in which 228 people died. Whereas the Bermuda Triangle and the Devil's Sea are merely lines drawn on a map, the South Atlantic Anomaly is a measurable physical presence. For years, there have been numerous technological failures. Things simple as a compass to technology as complex as the International Space Station. Many ships and aircraft that pass through the area have allegedly gone missing, and because of the technological interference in the area, many of the aircrafts and ships are never found because technology is needed to search for them. The magnetic interference is so great in the area that even the Hubble Space Telescope doesn't record while passing through the field. Astronauts on the International Space Station also do not perform spacewalks, as the radiation causes visual disturbances and often manifests as shooting stars. Number 4. The Alaskan Triangle, also known as Alaska's Bermuda Triangle. Spanning the vast southeastern reaches of the Alaskan wilderness up to its mountain ranges, an unusual number of hikers, boats, and planes vanish without a trace. In fact, the state of Alaska has not only twice the American national average of people reported missing, but also the lowest statistics for people found. Is it the unforgiving weather, wild animals, immense uncharted terrain, or something more sinister? The indigenous Tlingit people tell stories of a shape-shifting being called Kushtaka, meaning land otter man, who mimics the screams of children to lure unwary travelers to their deaths. Others blame Bigfoot, or propose that the area is a vile vortex like the Bermuda Triangle, linked to electromagnetic aberrations. Number 3. San Luis Valley in Colorado. This is a place where a cattle rancher came out to find almost all of his livestock had been completely murdered, skinned alive, with their organs almost surgically removed. Well, perhaps the most interesting part is that many of these animals were bled dry. This would become a center of alien conspiracy theory, as no clear explanations could ever be given as to why livestock was being slaughtered in mass numbers with barely a trace of blood. In one case, the only evidence that was found were three concentric burn marks near the corpses of the livestock. UFO enthusiasts believe that these are actually thrust marks from an extraterrestrial spaceship. There are also trace levels of radiation found on the sites of many of these massacres. Such an enormous massacre would have surely caused some kind of noise, right? Well, wrong. Almost all of the farmers who have experienced this phenomenon have not heard a single noise the night before. And in one of the more stranger cases, a farmer said that for some reason he slept for over 24 hours during the incident. In the years following the death of their livestock, many of these farmers have been unable to yield any kind of crops or harvest from their land because it had been drained of all its nutrients. One of the more eerie things to come out of the entire fiasco was an overarching sentiment among the farmers that they felt as though they were being watched. And for some reason, they could tell that whatever was watching them was not human. Could these be the ramblings of a farmer? Or have the farms been marked and there is actually someone watching them from above Earth? What do you think? Number 2. Island of the Dolls. As you navigate this creepy island just south of Mexico City, thousands of small, unblinking eyes watch your passage. The island is actually man-made, dating all the way back to the floating gardens of Aztec times. As legend has it, owner Julian Santana Barrera found a little drowned girl in the canal and a doll floating close by, which he hung in a tree as a sign of respect. But shortly following this act, he started to hear whispers, footsteps, and screams following him in the dark. Santana Barrera spent the next half century hanging dolls to pacify the girl's spirit. When he died in 2001, his body was eerily found in the same spot he had found the drowned girl. Number 1. The Nazca Lines.
The lines themselves directed you farther east.
Some 2,000 years ago, hundreds of complex geoglyphs were carved into the desert sands of southern Peru. Composed of over thousands of lines, the geometric figures and animal and plant designs cover an arid plateau south of Lima that's more than 50 miles in size. How were such complex designs created without aerial technology? Why did these people create shapes in the soil that are visible only from the air or hilltops? While scholars claim the lines were constructed using simple surveying equipment, others conjecture the use